mission station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Dan Hewitt. Expedition 53 began last weekend on the station when three crew members said farewell to their home in space. Peggy Whitson and Jack Fisher from NASA and Fyodor Yurchikhin from Roscosmos loaded into their Soyuz spacecraft and closed the hatches. After undocking, they dove through the atmosphere before a routine landing in Kazakhstan. Peggy Whitson returned as the most experienced American astronaut in history, with just over 665 days spent in space across three missions. Along with tying the record for most spacewalks by a NASA astronaut and working on hundreds of experiments, her latest flight was definitely one for the history books. Jack Fisher returns with his first flight complete and 136 days in space now on his awesome resume. And Fyodor Yurchikhin also wrapped up his third space flight and now has 673 days total in space, putting him just ahead of Peggy on the all-time endurance list. And while we here in Houston continue to recover from the impacts of Hurricane Harvey, the station had eyes on another monstrous storm churning across the Atlantic. External cameras captured these harrowing views of Hurricane Irma this week, which rapidly intensified into a Category 5 storm, the strongest possible level. With winds in excess of 185 miles per hour, the storm brought severe winds and rain to several islands across the Caribbean and could potentially impact mainland Florida and the Florida Keys. This week's Twitter question asks about a different kind of weather and comes from @Jugogene, who wants to know what kind of space weather Mission Control watches for the space station. That's a great question, especially since it means tracking something you can't usually see with the naked eye. Mission controllers and doctors keep a close watch on the conditions in space just around the Earth, focusing on the radiation and charged particles blasted into space by the sun. This is what we mean when we say space weather. Bad space weather has the potential to disrupt satellites and electronics and could give humans a higher dose of radiation if they are exposed, say during a spacewalk. Fortunately, the station is heavily shielded against events like this and even has extra fortified areas just in case the crew needs to weather an especially bad storm. Keep sending us your questions using the hashtag #SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.